Today marks the 7th annual Ball-In Beach event hosted by Fayetteville State University. Universities across the nation are unified together in helping to raise money through an annual basketball game spotlighting breast cancer awareness. Breast cancer survivors have been invited to today's game and offered special seating in the Chancellor section. Mrs. Nancy Anderson has spearheaded this effort. She is hosting a special reception for today's guests. Now, let's meet our special Ball-In Beach Warriors. Up first, we have a native of Sharpsburg, North Carolina. Let's welcome Mrs. Cynthia Pitt. Our next Ball-In Beach Warrior hails from Hope Mills, North Carolina. Mrs. Siobhan Kendrick. From nearby Rayford, North Carolina, we have Ball-In Beach Warriors, Mrs. Sabrina Holliday, Mrs. Ivana Richardson, and Mrs. Michelle Pope. Hailing all the way from Wilmington, North Carolina, let's welcome Mrs. Denise Bennett. And here locally in our area, we have a few Ball-In Beach Warriors from Fayetteville. Let's welcome Mrs. Val Applewhite. Mrs. Paula Frank. Patricia Chapman. And Sherry Manuel. Our next Ball-In Beach Warriors have very close ties to the Fayetteville State family. Our first warrior wears the hat of being the Broncos' current assistant athletic trainer. Let's hear it for Miss Erin Dell. Next, we have a student athlete that normally cheers for others. Today, we have the opportunity to salute and cheer her courage and strength. A member of the Fayetteville State cheerleading squad, cheered by Smooth, let's hear it for Miss Talia Green. Also, we have Miss Ann Casey from Raleigh, North Carolina. And finally, the woman who has championed this cause, let's give a round of applause to the University First Lady, Mrs. Nancy Anderson. And now, a few words from Mrs. Anderson.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome you to our 7th annual Ball-In Beach initiative. Our Ball-In Beach initiative raises funds for breast cancer survivors, and then we also like to educate individuals on the effects of breast cancer. I was reading a couple of facts about breast cancer that I don't know if you know. Is if you look around, one in every 8 women is going to have breast cancer. And men, you're not excluded. monthly exams. And last but not least, I have Winston-Salem State friend attending today's game. I will not call her by name, but Friday she had a lump removed from her breast. She will know next week the results. I'd like for all of us to keep her in prayer. Thank you very much. I will now turn this over to the chancellor.
Thank you, Nancy. We would like each of our survivors to tell the audience how long they have been in remission.
I've been in remission about 8 months.
I have been in remission for a year, but still going through chemo as of now.
8 years. 5 years. 10 years. 14 years. 14 years. Still fighting. 3 years. 1 month. 5 and a half years.
You are the class of
2013.
Class of
96.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand up. These are the real heroes. The real heroes. Not heroes, sheroes. Give them a round of applause.
The next presentation for $500 is being made by the Fayetteville Fort Bragg chapter of Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated. And the last presentation for the Ball and Pink Initiative is for $1,000 and being made by FSU alumna Latasha Bavetti, owner of Kids Play Daycare in Bronco Square. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give these donors and supporters a round of applause.
conversation.
Thank you.
donations. Money was being collected for cancer awareness, and we mentioned that if you donate a minimum of $2, you get registered to win a door prize. Well, we're about to announce the winners of those door prizes right now. We're going to draw 3 tickets, and check your ticket if you donate it, because you could be a winner of one of these door prizes. The first winner, if you have ticket number 360930, make your way to the scores table right now. 360930, you just won the door prize. Where you at? 360930. Our next winner, ticket number 360911. If you donated for the cancer awareness donation, and you got ticket number 360911, please make your way to the scores table. 360911. And our third winner, if you have ticket number 361055, you just won a door prize. Make your way to the scores table. 361055. If you enter to win a door prize by donating for cancer awareness, and you have ticket number 361055, ticket number 360930, or ticket number 360911, report to the score table immediately. Thank you.
Alfonso Key, head men's basketball coach at Fayetteville State University.
Claim your prize.
Alfonso Key, head men's basketball coach. Alfonso Key, head men's basketball coach at Fayetteville State University. Alfonso Key, head men's basketball coach at Thank you. Alfonso Key, head men's basketball coach at Fayetteville State University.
Attitude, set, rock on!
Family on three, fight on six. One, two, three, family. Four, five, six, fight.
Total chaos. And from a basketball perspective, our style of play, like the attack in an organized, chaotic way from a basketball perspective, want to play fast and really come down the floor in our set before you're ready, before you're organized, for 40 minutes, which causes chaos on your end defensively. And for us on the defensive end, we want to pressure the ball for 40 minutes through pressing, zone pressing, through man pressing, changing up of defenses, and making everything for you hard, not just physically, but mentally, making decisions. See character. You know, that word you hear 1,000 times in my practice, our classroom, our film character. At the end of the day, you've seen across the country, no matter how your talent develops you, your character will sustain you or destroy you. So we can make sure these young men, that word is critical. H is humility, because as hard as you work, your humble spirit will sustain your hunger and make you work hard. Once you think you've arrived in any aspect of your life, you think you're entitled, humbleness will leave you, and so will your riches and your opportunities. So we talk about being humble. Humble and hungry, okay? A is simplistic, just your attitude. You know, we talk about what separates good and great. So attitude is incredible. And also obedience. And that's a word that I kind of goes with authority. There's going to be a boss, and we must understand how to be obedient, not subservient, but there are rules in place. And I have to follow orders. We do as citizens. So obedience is critical. And success is the last S. And that's a choice. That is a choice. Success isn't magical. It is not by accident. It is a choice you make. So in the classroom, you choose to put those hours in to have success in that test. How you treat others every day is a choice you make, results in success. In the basketball court, your work ethic, your summer hours, those jump shots, those weights, it's a choice, not by accident. You have chosen to work hard as a student athlete to come to Fayetteville State. You chose not to stay at home and relax while you could be studying. You chose not to do the wrong thing. So those three, those acronyms, C-H-A-O-S, but overall, total chaos, organized chaos is our mantra. And I think those acronyms will carry you beyond Fayetteville State. Well, being named CIAA Coach of the Year in this awesome conference, these coaches, the role they played for years as educators, grooming young men at the same time, basketball elite level teaching, it's an honor to be said in that name and just to be in that category. A lot of my mentors are from this league. I moved from California to North Carolina here as a teenager, and the people that touched my lives weren't the guys on ESPN. There's a gentleman in Ohio Central, at Fayetteville State, Norfolk State, Winston-Salem State University. So those young men were powerhouses to me, and I could feel and touch them. So this would be named in that area as Coach of the Year of this league, which means more than basketball, is quite an honor. My greatest success thus far here would be, I think it was the year before last, there was an article out on my graduation rates, how it dwarfed the leagues, and even on campus, it was higher than the average graduation rate, including my manager, young lady that's been part of our program, she's in graduate school. So just during the process of building, recruiting certain student athletes through high school, change, and just having seen that article, realizing that over 90%, close to 90% have graduated, graduating at that level, the most proud I've received until future Shadow Blade Championship comes down the pike. What I sell parents, student athletes on in recruiting in the households are two different philosophies. One is our overall mantra talking about we will build a champion in three phases. Number one, a championship person, championship student, and athlete. So, you know, we don't have an imbalance of what we believe in. What does that mean? For example, well, we discipline on academics with results into great degrees, character-wise, young men recruit to be quality people. And so most parents want their children to be three-phase people, okay? The second one is there's nothing you can't get in Fayetteville State. Everybody wants to play professional basketball and get a degree. So for us, we've done both of those. It's not a dream, so there's nothing you can't get here. And then the nourishment of the student body, you know, we love you, and that's fact, and you'll be on that campus. Small is good sometimes. You know, attention is good sometimes. When people know your name and care for you. When I was here in school, I had teachers call me, you're late to class. So those combination of being a quality student, athlete, and person, and then reaching every goal a young man wants to reach academically and athletically from Fayetteville State. We have a young man now starting for us, Devin Thompson, born and raised here in Fayetteville. And he is a senior, going to graduate and have success. So, you know, you talk about proof. We got guys you can touch and feel that played at Fayetteville State, going on and made money playing basketball. Young men that have played high school basketball in Fayetteville had a great story here at Fayetteville State. So we want to show them some tangible examples of guys that have flourished in every capacity and succeeded at Fayetteville State and beyond. And we're excited, and we want to build a brick house, not a mobile home. A brick house takes a little while to build, but when it stands for a long time. We don't want to build a mobile home, a fly-by-night, a 1-2-year good team. We're going to be great in three areas. As I conclude, that's people number one, number two students, and three basketball players. And the next 10 to 15 years, not while they're here, my student athletes, but as you see them in life, they'll be champions forever.
Good sportsmanship starts with respect.
For yourself, your team, the opponent, and the decision of the officials.
At Fayetteville State University, conduct does count.
The athletes competing in this contest have trained many hours.
They have earned your respect and applause.
Your positive behavior will earn their respect for you.
Fayetteville State Athletics wants to remind you that you're a Bronco country.
A good sportsmanship zone.
No negative chants, yells, comments,
or acts directed to coaches, athletes, officials,
or fans will be tolerated.
The dictionary defines sportsmanship as
playing fair, being a good winner and loser.
We are Bronco Nation.
Ethics, integrity, and respect are values important in all our daily lives.
In athletics, those values are translated into the word sportsmanship.
Sportsmanship is one of the strongest educational lessons and lifetime values taught through intercollegiate athletics.
Responsible role models are those who practice good sportsmanship every day.
You can be a player, coach, administrator, spectator, or a parent and be a role model for all.
We often forget the importance of being gracious in victory.
The CIAA Conference reminds us that good sportsmanship gives us the standard to follow at all times.
We are Bronco Athletics. Thank you for your cooperation.
Attitude check! Broncos! Rise!
Hey Broncos, here on the campus of Fayetteville State University, we have the Rudolph Jones Student Center, otherwise known as the Student Center. Here we have a place to hang out, conduct business, and most of all, be who we are, students. FSU has invested large amounts of funds in order to make sure that we have a comfortable environment that we can call the best of the best. Here at our new and improved Student Center, we have a lot of new facilities for the students to use, such as the new and improved Student Leadership Suite. to the newly combined Bronco Grill and Game Room. To the newly built Student Center Movie Theater, aka the Bronco Cinema.
Approximately $23 million has been invested to ensure that we have a place to be ourselves and relax. But it is our job to help in the upkeep of our student center. So we have an excellent staff that make it look wonderful, but we have to do our part in ensuring that our student center is kept clean. Thank you.
We welcome you to the new and improved student center, and we encourage you all to utilize it and treat it with the utmost care and respect. Have fun with your friends. Sit down and relax. But most importantly, take pride in yourselves by taking pride in our new student center and keeping it clean. Attitude check!
Bronco!
Right?
JPEG was screaming across our broadband connection to 150 of your mom's friends.
At CenturyLink, we care about technology. More importantly, we care about reaching across the nation with our advanced broadband, entertainment, and voice to connect us all to what matters most, each other.
You never did that for me. Nice.
Because at CenturyLink, we know life is better, stronger connected.
Ladies and gentlemen, and the cable people, be sure to let your family and friends know that today's game can be seen live on television.
on EARC, Raleigh's Me TV, TV 64 in Charlotte, the Soul of the South Network, which includes Dayton, Columbus, Ohio, Magic Johnson Aspire TV Network, and WGHD 8.2 antenna in Winston-Salem and Greensboro.
Can you see by the thoughts of the light?
And now, let's meet the starting lineup for tonight's game, starting first with the visiting Rams. At the guard position for Winston-Salem State, a 6'3 senior from Houston, Texas, number 3, Damone Harris. At guard, a 6'2 senior from Fayetteville, North Carolina, number 23, C.J. Ford. At forward, a 6'8 senior from Raleigh, North Carolina, number 1, Keith Armstrong. Also at forward, a 6'5 senior from Raleigh, North Carolina, number 4, Raymond Harris. At center, a 6'5 freshman from Bethel, North Carolina, number 22, William Crandall. Coaching staff from Winston-Salem State University, James Wilhelm. And now, let's meet the starting lineup for your Fayetteville State Broncos! At forward for Fayetteville State, a 6'6 freshman from Winston-Salem, North Carolina, number 14, William Tim. Also at forward, a 6'8 junior from Raleigh, North Carolina, number 21, Chason Lee. At center for Fayetteville State, a 6'7 junior from Kingston, North Carolina, number 22, Michael Tyson. At guard for Fayetteville State, a 6'2 junior from Kingston, North Carolina, wearing number 2, Joshua Dawson. And at guard for Fayetteville State, a 6'1 rising sophomore from Roper, North Carolina, number 5, Carl McCray. Coaching staff for Fayetteville State, head coach Alphonse Key, associate head coach Corey Johnson, assistant coach Amy Clark. Ladies and gentlemen, for Fayetteville State University Broncos.
Yeah! Yeah.
for number two, Terrell Leach.
Broncos
number 21, Jason Lee.
Oh, whoa.
two on the line, shooting two, number 21, Jason Lee.
Hold it, hold it!
Count it! Back in the game for the fans. Number 23, CJ Ford.
Slash.
Back in the game for the Broncos, number 14.
break. Media timeout.
Come on.
the soul of the South Network, which includes Dayton and Columbus, Ohio, Magic Johnson's Inspire TV Network, and WGHB 8.2 Antenna TV in Winston-Salem, Greensboro.
Travel. Close to 70 undergrad and graduate programs in state-of-the-art facilities on this lovely campus, students are proud to be a part of the FSU family. Visit our website and learn more about why.
Understanding what it takes to preserve that rich legacy
the 1000 Broncos campaign was established. The 1000 Broncos is the official fundraising arm of FSU Athletics. Today, three supporters of Broncos Athletics are making contributions to support our student athletes. First, we have FSU alumna Latasha Bethay, owner of Kids Play Daycare in Bronco Square. Ms. Bethay is presenting a check for $50,000.
Alfonso Key, head men's basketball coach at Fayetteville State University.
Attitude, set,
rock on!
Family on 3506. 1, 2, 3, family. 4, 5, 6, 5.
Total chaos. And from a basketball perspective, our style of play, like the attack in an organized, chaotic way from a basketball perspective, want to play fast and really come down the floor in our sets before you're ready, before you're organized, for 40 minutes, which causes chaos on your end defensively. And for us on the defensive end, we want to pressure the ball for 40 minutes through pressing, zone pressing, through man pressing, changing up of defenses, and making everything for you hard, not just physically, but mentally, making decisions. See character. You know, that word you hear 1,000 times in my practice, our classroom, our film, character. At the end of the day, you've seen across the country, no matter how your talent develops you, your character will sustain you or destroy you. So we can make sure these young men, that word is critical. H is humility, because as hard as you work, your humble spirit will sustain your hunger and make you work hard. Once you think you've arrived in any aspect of your life, or you think you're entitled, humbleness will leave you, and so will your riches and your opportunities. So we talk about being humble, humble and hungry, okay? A is simplistic, just your attitude. You know, you talk about what separates good and great, so attitude is incredible, and also obedience. And that's a word that I kind of goes with authority. There's going to be a boss, and we must understand how to be obedient, not subservient, but there are rules in place. And I have to follow orders, we do as citizens, so obedience is critical. And success is the last S, and that's a choice. That is a choice. Success isn't magical, it is not by accident, it is a choice you make. So in the classroom, you choose to put those hours in to have success in that test. How you treat others every day is a choice you make, results in success. In the basketball court, your work ethic, your summer hours, those jump shots, those weights, it's a choice, not by accident. You have chosen to work hard as a student athlete to come to Fayetteville State. You chose not to stay at home and relax while you could be studying. You chose not to do the wrong thing. So those three, those acronyms, C-H-A-O-S, but overall, total chaos, organized chaos, is our mantra. And I think those acronyms will carry you beyond Fayetteville State. Well, being named CIAA Coach of the Year in this awesome conference, these coaches, the role they played for years as educators, grooming young men, at the same time, basketball elite level teaching. It's an honor to be said in that name and just to be in that category. A lot of my mentors are from this league. I moved from California to North Carolina here as a teenager, and the people that touched my lives weren't the guys on ESPN. There's a gentleman in Ohio Central, like Fayetteville State, Norfolk State, Winston-Salem State University. So those young men were powerhouses to me, and I could feel and touch them. So they should be named in that area as coach of the year in this league, which means more than basketball. It's quite an honor. My greatest success thus far here would be, I think it was the year before last, there was an article out on my graduation rates. I would dwarf the leagues and even on campus, it was higher than the average graduation rate, including my manager, a young lady that's been part of our program, she's in graduate school. So just during the process of building, recruiting certain student athletes through high school change, and just seeing that article, realizing that over 90%, close to 90% have graduated, graduating at that level, the most proud I've received until future CIAA championship comes down the pike. What I sell parents, student athletes on in recruiting in the households are two different philosophies. One is our overall mantra talking about we will build a champion in three phases. Number one, a championship person, championship student, and athlete. So, you know, we don't have an imbalance of what we believe in. What does that mean for an example? Well, we discipline on academics, which results into great degrees, character-wise, young men recruit to be quality people. And so most parents want their children to be three-phase people, okay? The second one is there's nothing you can't get in Fayetteville State. And everybody wants to play professional basketball and get a degree. So for us, we've done both of those. It's not a dream, so there's nothing you can't get here. And then the nourishment of the student body, you know, we love you, and that's fact, and you'll be on that campus. Small is good sometimes, you know, attention is good sometimes. When people know your name and care for you. When I was here in school, I had teachers call me, you're late to class. So those combination of being a quality student, athlete, and person, and then reaching every goal a young man wants to reach academically and athletically from Fayetteville State. We have young men now starting for us, Devin Thompson, born and raised here in Fayetteville, and he is a senior, going to graduate and have success. So, you know, you talk about proof. We got guys that can touch the field that played at Fayetteville State, going on and made money playing basketball. Young men that have played high school basketball in Fayetteville had a great story here at Fayetteville State. So we're going to show them some tangible examples of guys that have flourished in every capacity and succeeding at Fayetteville State and beyond. And we're excited, and we want to build a brick house, not a mobile home. Brick house takes a little while to build, but when it stands for a long time. We don't want to build a mobile home or fly by night and 1-2 year good team. We're going to be great in three areas. As I conclude, that's people number one, number two students, and three basketball players. And the next 10 to 15 years, not while they're here, my student athletes, but as you see them in life, they'll be champions forever.
Good sportsmanship starts with respect.
For yourself, your team, the opponent, and the decision of the officials.
At Fayetteville State University, conduct does count.
The athletes competing in this contest have trained many hours.
They have earned your respect and applause.
Your positive behavior will earn their respect for you.
Fayetteville State Athletics wants to remind you that you're a Bronco country.
A good sportsmanship zone.
No negative chants, yes, comments,
or acts directed to coaches, athletes, officials,
or fans will be tolerated.
The dictionary defines sportsmanship as
playing fair, being a good winner and loser.
We are Bronco Nation.
Ethics, integrity, and respect are values important in all our daily lives.
In athletics, those values are translated into the word sportsmanship.
Sportsmanship is one of the strongest educational lessons and lifetime values taught through intercollegiate athletics.
Responsible role models are those who practice good sportsmanship every day.
You can be a player, coach, administrator, spectator, or a parent and be a role model for all.
We often forget the importance of being gracious in victory.
The CIAA Conference reminds us that good sportsmanship gives us the standard to follow at all times.
We are Bronco Athletics. Thank you for your cooperation.
Attitude check! Bronco!
Thank you. Yeah. Dress you go there.
Change your plans, baby.
Real taste, zero sugar. It's possible.
Hey, must provide the ultimate photo booth experience for all events.
Shall we stand the box?
Yes, the fun and entertaining experience of the customized photo booth. Photo booth takes factory memories to a new level, providing a wide selection of props and offering a selection of backgrounds. See what everyone is buzzing about. Book your photo booth.
Thank you.
Thank you. That's his first. His number five takes that in for the Broncos, Paul McRae. Back in the game for the Ravens, number one, Keith Armstrong.
Thank you. Line number 24, TJ Wilson.
At the line shooting two, number 11, Juwan Addison.
Thank you. will. 42 can shoot. Thank you.